Canva just got so much better. With these new Canva updates, your designs will be much more engaging, you can now create more quickly, use new exciting effects, and even collaborate in fun ways. Ready? Let's do this. Hi, my lovely people, it's Natalia, and welcome back to my channel where I help you create better content and grow on social media. And today, I'm back with another Canva tutorial slash Canva tips and tricks video to help you discover some of the most recent exciting updates. If you already know Canva and want to use it more effectively, you're in for a treat because we have some very fresh news and some hidden gems that you probably haven't heard of. If I helped you find a tip that you liked, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe for more videos. And without further ado, let's jump right on in. Update number one, remove video background. This latest Canva update is mind-blowing. Do you know you can remove backgrounds from any image in Canva? It's like the favorite feature for everyone. Well, now you can do the same thing with videos. Yes, you can now do it with one click and it's absolutely amazing. To do this, find any video from the library or upload yours, then select it. And just like with an image, you'd click edit image here at the top. Now you choose edit video and here's our background remover. And see, it works like magic. Now imagine all the different things you can do with it. First of all, with the Canva video editor, you can use different animated green screen elements from the library and use them as overlays on your videos. If you're feeling a bit more funky and want to extend your personal brand a little, you can create GIFs or even animations of you to use within your designs. It's also a cool option if you're creating a reel in Canva and want to replicate the green screen effect that we know so well from Instagram or TikTok. Or you can just use your clip and switch up the background for something completely different. So many great possibilities from this one update. What you need to know about the new Canva video background remover is that it is still in beta phase, so it definitely works better with simple backgrounds. However, I'm sure it's going to get even better over time, just like with the second update. And now, before I move on, I'd love for you to join the waitlist for my upcoming Canva course. It's a full comprehensive course that's going to help you master the platform and efficiently design engaging graphics for your business and social media. The link is in the description down below. Update number two, PDFs. Another exciting update that Canva released is the PDF editor, and this is the feature we had in beta for a while, but we now have access to the fully developed function. You can simply upload your PDF from the homepage and Canva is going to, again, work its magic to break it down into separate editable elements. So say you have a flat PDF, meaning a PDF that's not been saved with the layers retained. You can now click create a design here on the homepage, click import file and choose this PDF. Canva is going to create a new project for you and identify all the different text boxes, images and graphics so you can edit them freely. Just look at this PDF that I've just uploaded. Instead of a flat document, I now have a fully editable design, and that's a game changer in my opinion. When I first talked about the beta version of the Canva PDF editor, I said it's not always perfect and that it doesn't get a lot of things right. Well, this is now much, much improved. You can see that I can now change the font of the headline here at the top. I can make this image bigger or smaller. I can move the arrow here because Canva perfectly identified this as an element. And what's new and really cool is that I can now treat it as an editable element, just like some of the ones in the Canva library, and change the colors to whatever I want. It even divided the colors for the body of the arrow or the shaft, right? The dashed lines and the point of the arrow. How cool is that? I'm so happy that it's now a full release because before I would not have been able to grab these numbers here from behind the text box. It wouldn't be identified correctly by Canva, but now, easy peasy, I can just grab them, change the color, move them around. So cool. Of course, editing the PDFs is the most exciting part of this new update, but I want to mention the other possibilities that this editor gives us. So often we have to merge PDF files, reorder the pages, move something from one page to the other, and now all of this is possible within Canva. I can import two PDFs, go to the thumbnail view, and literally copy over entire pages of the document to the next one. If I just want one page, I can do that too and easily download the PDF with the current page option. We no longer need to use Adobe Acrobat Pro or look for free online editors like Small PDF to be able to do all of these things. Not to mention, you can now use your existing PDFs and transform them into presentations or social media designs. And if you've gone through the process of rebranding, you'll be able to apply your new brand guidelines to your PDF very easily. By the way, if you're always on the lookout for more cool Canva content like this, make sure you subscribe and you can check out this video next to discover Canva tips and tricks you might not have heard about before. Update number three, new shapes features. You probably know that you've always had access to a variety of generic shapes within the Canva editor. You had your standard circle and a rectangle and a triangle, but you couldn't do much with them other than stretch them out in different directions or change their color. Now we have a whole new layer of editing available within these simple shapes. Let me add a rectangle so you can see what I'm talking about. First of all, you can see straight away a text bar is flashing within the shape, meaning we can start typing whatever we want, and it's going to act like a text box. The top panel has some new functions, and the text options are readily available for you there. So notice this shape button at the very beginning. When you click on it, we can change the rectangle into any other one from the shapes library, which makes it very handy, especially when you include text there. That's already quite a useful improvement, but I want to move on to the part that excites me the most, and that's the button with these little unassuming lines. It looks simple, but it hides a few really cool options that we've missed from within Canva. First of all, you can add a border and choose anything from a plain line, dashed lines, all the way to the dotted effect. Pretty cool. Of course, then you can adjust the border weight just like this from this slider. And now for what's my favorite shape update, the corner rounding. Let me just remove that from here. I love this feature. It definitely makes my life much easier when I'm trying to search for a specific element to achieve this look. It's so simple. It has the power to really transform the shapes you're using. And when you think about it, if your brand is a bit more organic in feel, you don't use many harsh lines, this feature is going to help you a ton. So let's switch this rectangle to a harsher shape like this four-pointed star, and it just completely transforms the shape. That's definitely a much needed update from Canva. Update number four. Whiteboards. We're getting more options to actively collaborate in Canva as teams. The new feature is called Whiteboards and is the perfect tool to brainstorm, to plan, to work on projects, collaborate during meetings, basically anything you do with a big whiteboard and a group of people in real life. There are already so many templates for you to use from the library to inspire you and help you use this new feature. And you have a remote meetings whiteboard, project journey templates, voting boards, diagrams, mood boards, mind maps, and even games. It's actually quite incredible how many options we get so early after the launch of this new option. I highly recommend you scroll through the extended library of templates to see what may work for you personally and within your workflow. When you choose a whiteboard template to work from, or actually create a blank one because you can do that too, you're taken to a whiteboard editor, and this is the part of its magic. It kind of is infinite. I mean, technically it isn't. When you zoom out, you'll see there's a limit, but from a practical standpoint, you'd be pressed to try and use up all that space. When you zoom in, you can see how close you can get to specific elements, which gives you almost a tunnel vision, but I'll get back to it in a moment. Within our elements tab in the left panel, you'll notice some of the new whiteboard specific categories like your sticky notes in here, stickers or whiteboard graphics, and the regular library is available to you too. Now, when you look at this particular template, and it's quite similar in many others, you see that they've prepared a bunch of different elements for you and your team to use. You can literally duplicate a sticky note from here and add it to a specific board, just like any of the connectors or stickers. There's also this mode called Quick Flow, which allows you to do all of these things even quicker. So let's say I have a new strength to add to this column. Unless I want a specific element from the master board here, I can literally just select the sticky note and hit the plus sign wherever I want to add a new one, and it creates a new one beneath straight away, just to the side like this. So cool. And you can do it for other elements too, like this big one right here, and it was gonna pop up just beneath it. If you don't like it or don't need it, you simply right-click on any element and select Disable Quick Flow. If you ever need more space anywhere, you can easily just stretch out the elements as you would in a regular Canva editor. And with each of the elements, you and your team members can add comments anywhere they want, so it makes for an even more collaborative workspace. Another thing I want to mention is that you have the timer here at the bottom, so you can time each member of the whiteboard and make sure everyone gets enough time. So you can also time your sessions. It's so useful and a really nice touch for team collaboration. Whiteboards save within your projects like a regular design would, and when you're done collaborating, you can export the finished whiteboard as a PDF or a JPEG or even as a video if you've used any animated or video elements. I'll be honest, even without a team, the whiteboard feature is really interesting to me, and when I first saw it, I was definitely inspired by all the possibilities, so I'm curious what you think about it. Update number five, Canva websites. I've included websites in the first video on Canva tips and tricks, but now we're getting something even better. With the official launch of the full Canva websites feature, we can now turn PDFs, documents, or presentations into simple, responsive websites, and it's a responsiveness that seems to really have been improved. We're now getting device previews. We previously had no options with our own domains, but now we can purchase a branded domain from within Canva, or later on, I think, use a domain we ourselves own. Although a simple Canva website cannot really replace a fully fleshed out professional website to represent your brand online, I think this new update is fantastic for a variety of simple applications. The biggest upside, no coding or previous experience with websites required. You can now create your own media kit, a simple landing page or a press release. If you're looking for a job, this can be a website slash resume to showcase your experience. You can use it to create resources for your clients or even a personalized dashboard for them. As an artist or a designer, this can be a great way to build and be able to quickly update your own portfolio. If you create websites for clients, this feature allows you to share mockups with them and work out the finer details before you build the official website elsewhere. I've previously shared a tutorial on how to create a link in bio through Canva for your Instagram link, and there are really plenty of different ways you can use Canva websites in your business and life. The great thing about this new Canva update is that we can now have access to hundreds of templates, and then we can create using all the lovely elements and photos and videos from the Canva library. Another amazing feature is that we can keep the website private by adding a password or choosing to hide it from search engines, which again works brilliantly if you're creating something for a client. And of course, no website would give you a good overview of your visitors if it didn't provide you with analytics, so Canva took care of this too. We're getting access to website insights which can help us track views, clicks, and engagement on our new page. Update number 6. Text-to-image app. Yes, you've heard me right, it's text-to-image and not text-to-speech or any similar combination that we already know and use. Within this new feature within the Canva editor, you can generate new ideas from a simple description, and let me show you how it works. Let's say I need an image for an upcoming post and I have a rough idea as to what it should include. When I click more here in the panel, you can see the new text-to-image tab right here, and when I select it, it allows me to type a simple sentence to then create an image for me within seconds. Sounds pretty cool, right? I can let Canva generate any image that it feels will look best, and I can also choose a drawing, a photo, a 3D image, a pattern, or concept art. Now, granted, this feature is brand new and it's still very much in the beta stage, but just like with the PDFs, I expect it to get much, much better. It can be used to create unique images that may surpass the need for stock images in the future. It's also a great way to stir your own imagination and help you come up with new ideas for your designs. I'm very curious to see where Canva takes this new feature. Update number 7. Quick Read. If you're on multiple platforms, you'll know how hard it is to create posts for each and every one of them and make sure they're all the right size and vibe. Sure, you can design one post and then use a resize button if you're a pro user, but the downside is that you have to do it each time and adjust accordingly so that it looks good. If you've created a post for Instagram, you want to repurpose it for Pinterest, and that's going to be much more vertical, so it's going to move the elements around. Then you want a visual for Twitter, and that's a completely different size too, so you adjust it. Again, in short, it's not effortless. Well, as usual, Canva decided to deliver. With a quick create update, we now have the possibility to, well, quickly create a bunch of posts from the same template with a few clicks. If you've ever used Tailwind for Pinterest, you'll know they had a similar option and was so helpful for creators on the platform so they could produce a lot of similar pins all at once. Now, if you want to try the quick create feature in Canva, it's slightly hidden and not so obvious. You'll need to go to the social media tab in here on the homepage, right beneath the big search bar, and you'll find it at the first option here. When you're in this new type of editor, it allows you to speed design a square Instagram post and a vertical story, a Facebook post and a cover, which is helpful if, for example, you're planning a new campaign, a Twitter post, a Pinterest pin, a LinkedIn post, and an email header, because let's not forget, among all the social media portals, it's always crucial to have a platform that you yourself own, so I love that it's there. Once you select which placements you want, you can add your primary and secondary text, add an image and a logo. Then you'll be able to quickly choose the style from the library of templates. And I feel like at the moment, the selection is slightly limited compared to what we're used to seeing in the Canva library, but the update is fairly new, so I expect it to be expanded in the future. I hope at least. And now for the absolute banger, we always want our designs to keep with our overall brand image. We need to keep a consistent look, and that's where our trusty brand kit comes into play. You can now select your own color palette or choose something from the additional ones suggested by Canva, and you can apply your own fonts too. I always emphasize it, this is what really sets apart a newbie from a more professional creator. You always want to make sure you're keeping a consistent brand image, and that's why this part is so important. If you keep on clicking on the palettes, the colors will shuffle and you'll see a lot more variety so that you end up with a well-matched design. When you're done, you can just click finish, wait for Canva to do its magic, and voila, you can now download a whole pack of your new designs ready to be uploaded across all platforms. How cool is that? One honorable mention that I want to include here that's not yet launched is Canva Docs. They've been announced at the Canva Create 2022 conference, and it looks like it's going to be another very exciting addition to the platform. Going beyond the boundaries of the classic documents, we'll be able to combine rich text, various media from the library, as well as some new data visualizations like new graphs, charts, checklists, and tables. Plus, it seems that we're getting insights within this new feature too. I joined the waitlist for Docs in beta, so I'll report back once I know more and hopefully had a chance to test them. Have you discovered something new and exciting today? Jump to the comment section quickly and let me know which update is your favorite. Now, if you want more great tips, check out the first installment of the Canva Tips and Tricks. And for more quick Canva tutorials, head on over to this playlist and see what you can create yourself. If you're serious about mastering Canva and using it for social media or your business, sign up on the waitlist for my upcoming Canva course so that you can become a pro yourself. I have more exciting content coming up with some Canva videos as well, so make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you don't miss them. If you have any questions or any other cool Canva tips, share them in the comments below. I'm all about community here, so let's help each other out. Like this video if you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.